Is there anything that you think that the team might be missing that Hughes can kind of bring to the table?
Yeah, I mean, just from a training standpoint for the kids that we have now, like I said, just being able to get in some sand pits during the indoor season, that will ultimately benefit for them for the outdoor season. And then, I mean, just having some more reps and that kind of stuff. And then just from the way that our track is now comparatively to this, for our sprinters and even for our high jumpers and our pole vaulters, those will be able to recover a lot quicker from jump workouts when they're actually high jumping or when they're actually pole vaulting. Because our facility that we have now, I mean, it is somewhere to train, don't get me wrong. I mean, we're grateful for that we can, you know, go over hurdles and vault and high jump inside, because there's a lot of Division II places or NAI or whatever that don't have that at all, you know, so we're really fortunate for that. But it's just a hard and old surface, so it takes a few days longer than you'd like it to when you're having those jump workouts. So like I said, that would just be tremendous to have access to those kind of whenever we want for indoor. And even our throwers, I mean, right now we have one ring for our throwers, and they have to schedule their practices around the track team and tennis and basketball and volleyball and all sorts of stuff. So for years they've gone really early in the morning. So that's not ideal when you're throwing around a 35-pound weight, because it just takes a little bit longer to get warmed up, and a lot of times they're doing it right after they've lifted and stuff like that. So just for them to be able to maybe practice a little bit later in the day or break up a lifting and throwing session, I mean, that would be really tremendous for them too.